opened today. Hallelujah. He opened up a way. Hallelujah today. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Can you imagine hanging before the whole world and say, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they do. Now, the same words being echoed throughout the those that know Jesus throughout our society today. Father, forgive them. They don't know what they do. Can you hear me today? Father, forgive them. They don't know what they do. Well, I'm here to celebrate life with Jesus Christ. I thank God for what he's done in our lives. Can you hear that today? Hallelujah. When you get uncomfortable, they tell me that God's growing you. Is anybody uncomfortable? Da-da-da. Is anybody uncomfortable? Well, I got them both. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm not uncomfortable with God. It just, sometimes I just like to have the roadmap. Say, go left, turn right, go left, turn right, go straight ahead, stop. Sometimes he does that, don't he? But thank God Almighty. Hallelujah. It's a privilege to serve a living God. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to stand for the Lord. I'm going to stand for the Lord. I'm going to stand for the Lord. An old infantry principle, those of you who are in the service, is you don't leave your position until you're dead or you are relieved of your commands. Anybody with me?
Yeah.
You do not leave the position God's put you in. I'm not talking about a building. I'm talking about the position that God's put you in. You don't leave that position until he takes you out. You might want to leave. Is anybody with me? You might want to leave. You might want to get up and run. You might want to drop everything and take off, but you can't because God said, hold on. Boom, 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 boom. Help is on the way. Boom, 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 boom. Please, please send help. Boom, 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 boom. Help is on the way. Thank you, Father. Glory to God. We do declarations here. Why do we do that? It's because the word is the truth, and the truth will set me free. And I declare that Jesus Christ is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Come on, somebody. If he can give a quarterback $28 million in a three-year contract, what?
Yeah.
Don't get mad at me, football. They tell me we're short of money. I said, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Maybe short a little bit down here in the food pantry, but they ain't short out on the field.
That's right.
Direct some of that over this way. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So in that, we're going to declare, and let's do it together, and do it like, I want to say it like I mean. Can we do that? Here we go. God richly supplies all my financial needs. Let's do it again. God richly supplies all my financial needs. Let's do it one more time. I'll get it down in here. God richly supplies all my financial needs. Philippians 4:19. Not welfare, not government, not Cummins Engine Company, not CEO, is anybody with me? It's God supplies all my financial needs. I need to say it, Brother Tom, until it's in here. And once I say it long enough, then it gets here and it gets here. Then I begin to believe God's supplying all my financial needs. God is the one who gave me that. God is the one who gave me that. I got a testimony on that too. Hallelujah. Let's say this together, 4:19. Can we say it together? Let's say it real slow. But my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. By who? Christ Jesus. When he hung on the cross and the last thing he said, it's finished. Debbie, it's up to you now. Come on, it's finished. Amen. And then when he left, he said, hey, I'm just leaving for a while. I'm just going to be gone for a little bit, but while I'm gone, I'll send you a comforter. I'm going to send you the Holy Ghost. People said, I don't need that. Well, God sent my promise to me, and it was my comforter. Come on, somebody. Where can I find comfort when Duke Energy said, I'm shutting your power off?
Yeah.
Where can I find comfort, the mayor? No, Duke will shut you off in a heartbeat. Blah. Where can I find comfort? Only through the Holy Ghost. Come on in a testimony. I'm driving down the road the other day, and I was a little bit frustrated, and it's all right by testifying on these needs, and my box truck, the brakes went out, and I drove all the way from Columbus back here praying to get back with both brake lights on that box truck. I said, Lord, help me to get home. I want to get home. Thank you, Jesus. He helped me to get home. Yeah. He got me home, got me over there, and they said, we'll fix that. The brake line's broke. Cost you $114. I said, okay. My other truck drive went out of that pickup truck, and it was out of Bob Pointer's, and as soon as you walk in the door, you hear cha-ching. What's that noise? Oh, nothing. Cha-ching. Anybody with me? You got to pray when you go into them places. They got a thing up there, $60 for this and $80 for that and $100 for this. And I got to take out a bank loan. I'm going, oh, God. So I got a little frustrated, and I'm driving down the road. And then lo and behold, they take my truck in, and the lady says, here, come over here. I'll just give you a brand-new truck to drive while we're working on yours. I said, oh. I said, please don't give me a new truck. So I got a brand-new Chevy truck. I'm driving around on Steyr, backup camera. Push the button. Hello, is anybody there? Talking on the phone. Is anybody with me?
Yeah.
This is about what God does. Amen. So I'm driving down the road, and I just told the Lord, I said, I need $500. I have a need. I need $500. Didn't hear a word. I need $500. Didn't hear a thing. Still frustrated driving. I just need it, God. I hate to ask you, but I need it. So I went over here, and I was at church for a while, and I went to my office and sat down. I sat back, and I just needed it, Lord. The phone rings, and I pick it up. The lady says, Gary, I was praying, and God brought your name to me, and he gave me a figure of money I'm supposed to give you. I said, he did? Is anybody with me? I said, he did? Now, I just saying, this is just 2 hours ago, I asked for $5. She said, well, I called somebody else for verification, and I said, we want to give this to his ministry, and what figure do you have? And he said, well, give him $500. She said, well, that's what God told me to give him, $500. I said, what? Is God listening? Is God hearing the prayer? But the need, I mean, she said, by the end of the day, you'll have it in your food pantry or your book. I said, is anybody with me? God richly supplied. He said he's abundantly able to do above what I can even say, think, or ask. He knows what I need before I even ask. Help me to get right position with God. When I'm in right position, seek first the kingdom of God, and then, so we're here today to seek God. I'm gonna look at him. I'm gonna direct my praise to him. I'm gonna seek the Lord today. I'm not seeking for money. I'm not seeking anything. And I told people, I said, when he explodes over southern Indiana, I don't have to be anything but in it. Is anybody with me? I'll open the door. I'll haul the garbage. I just want to be in it. Can anybody say I want to be in it? Tell him, I want to be in it, God. I want to be in it. He's going to explode over southern Indiana, and it's going to make a difference. I don't care what they're doing out there. Shoom! When he explodes, look out. Man, we'll be fireballs. The light and the salt. 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 Brother Tom, we're the light and the salt. The light and the salt. It's dark out there, but we're the light and the salt. Sister Debbie, you're a light. I don't care what they say about you. You're a light. Brother in that truck, you're a salt. Now listen, I want to encourage you. If you feel something today, to pray for somebody, do it. Don't let me sit over here hurting and then say, yeah, I'm going to be. I'm just getting on here. Come on, do it, because they may need a healing. And I'm going to talk about healing. Let's keep talking about healing until we're all healed. Amen. Glory to God. So I'm going to open it up with prayer. This is the river. This is a come as you are, get down here and praise the Lord. Brother Tom, we got free will to get down here and praise God. So let's stand and open it up in prayer. Can we do that? Oh, praise God. Praise God. Father, we just offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. We declare today that we're mobile tabernacles of the Holy Ghost and fire and power. We've come here today with a sole purpose to worship you, to thank you, and to love on you today, God. And we say thank you, Lord, that you are our Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Tishkenu, Jehovah Makedesh, Jehovah Rohi, my peace, my joy, my healer. You're the everything today. God, set us on fire that we can go out and burn this town up in Jesus' holy name, Father. Thank you, Father. Can everybody say praise the Lord? Come on, let's worship him today. Hallelujah.
I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three. believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name of
in the saints' communion and in your holy church.
I believe in the resurrection when Jesus comes again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name.
We shall meet on that beautiful
we stand and lift up our hands. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. We bow down and worship Him now. How great, how awesome is He. And together we sing. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with His glory. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. The earth is filled with His glory. The earth is filled with His glory. We stand and lift up our hands. For the joy of the Lord is our strength. We bow down and worship Him now. How great, how awesome is He. And together we sing. Everyone sing. Holy is the Lord. Slam. King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
delivering people, healing people, encouraging people. Lord, just loving on people, Lord. Loving on one another. Loving God. Yes. Yes, Lord, we just praise you this morning, God. You have brought us together to love on you, God. That there might be a communion here this morning, God, between us, Lord. That there might be just a relationship, Lord, that would just help us in every way. For we all need help from you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, come on, come on. Step into it. Woo, God. Ooh. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Stand up, Marlene. Thank you, Jesus. I haven't told Marlene this yet, but last night, sometime in the night, I don't know when it was. I don't think it was this morning. I don't know when it was. It did, but there's a faint remembrance. You know, she's been limping around here. I seen her seem like just a melting, like honey would flow, you know, just out of a big bucket, just float up on her, and she just walked right out of it. No limping, no pain. And so, Lord, I just want to speak into that. And, Lord, we're talking about the wind to blow, fire to burn. Lord, we just thank you, God, as the sweetness of your love to flow over Marlene. And anybody else in here need a little bit of it, just grab a hold of it. It's not just for her. I think it's for the body of Christ. Lord, let the sweetness of your love flow over us. Lord, and we'll be able to walk right out of whatever it is that's holding us back. It might not be physical. Maybe it's spiritual. Maybe it's mental. Maybe it's emotionally somehow. Lord, but the sweetness of your love, Lord, let it flow over us, and that we'll be able, Lord, just to walk out of it a new person in Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you. Hallelujah. I don't need right now. That is the oil. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now let's walk up this hill here. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Woo, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. You know, it's that simple, isn't it? In Jesus. There's power. There's glory. In Jesus' name. Peter said, you know, don't be amazed. It's not because of our righteousness that this man stands before you whole. But it is through the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you have crucified. Oh, yeah, hallelujah. 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 Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Woo! Thank you, Lord. Woo! Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For you got it. All right, go for it. Thank you, Jesus.
Woo! Hallelujah. For the presence of the Almighty Spirit of the Living God. I just got to testify before Debbie does the song, because last night, many of you might know, I had a 45th high school reunion. You know, what a great time to get together with old friends. And Debbie and I just prayed, Lord, just use us. And I was so looking forward to this time, because there's a band that has just started about a year ago. Fred Booker, who's a little older than I, but he's got a band again, and he's got the sweetest voice in the world. The Lord has blessed him. How many know Fred? Here knows Fred Booker. Well, we get there, and everyone starts talking about Fred's got colon cancer.